Tom Hanks may not play his usual self in Road to Perdition, but that's not necessarily a bad thing.
Canada be damned. I'm going to the Klondike.
The Klondike is Canada.
Giorgio, you be doing just fine, brother.
I'm sure it goes without saying, but I love movies. Like everybody, I have my preferences, which is why I don't cover horror films that much. But even when it comes to horror films, there's still the odd one which gets me stoked, and I'm more than willing to champion them like any film from any other genre. The thing I cannot champion is the type of film that continues to recycle the same old tricks, tropes, gimmicks, and even plot lines, simply because they've become so frequent, they've come to be expected. It's lazy, and this is a big reason why I've said goodbye to comic book adaptations since the announcement of Disney Plus, and most likely why I'm feeling the effects of superhero fatigue. I need something different. I crave something different. And that something doesn't have to be particularly special, it just has to be, well, different. Sam Mendes' 2002 Depression-era drama Road to Perdition is by no means a superhero adaptation, although it is adapted from a graphic novel. It brings us into the family of the Sullivans, the father being Michael Sr., played by Tom Hanks, and his eldest son Michael Jr., played by Tyler Hoechlin. Michael Sr. has another family, both literally and figuratively, with Irish mobsters John and Connor Rooney, played by Paul Newman and Daniel Craig, as Michael Sr.'s adoptive father and brother, as well as fellow wise guys. What exactly Michael Sr. does isn't exactly clear, but it's apparent it's not on the up and up.
What's Papa's job? He works for Mr. Rooney. Why? Well, Papa didn't have a father, so Mr. Rooney looked after him.
I know that, but what's his job?
Peter, I can't come to your concert tonight. I'm working.
Working at what? Putting food on your plate, young man.
Curiosity getting the better of him, Michael Jr. positions himself as a stowaway on his father's latest errand, and witnesses Sr. and Connor murder multiple people. This in turn drives a wedge between both families as Connor murders half of the Sullivans, which forces Jr. and Sr. to hit the road.
This house is not our home anymore. It's just an empty building.
And redefines their roles as their world is turned upside down.
All right, you stay here. You stay out of sight.
Don't go, Pa. Don't go.
Michael.
Don't go.
Tomorrow when they find out we're gone, they're gonna come after us. I have to protect you now.
Although the premise of Road to Perdition may not be something different, casting Tom Hanks in this type of role is. Up to this point in his career, Tom Hanks typically gave us a type of leading character that's light like Big, or heroic like Apollo 13, but with the questionable exception of Saving Private Ryan, Hanks never gave us a character that's quite like this. One that's hard as
Think, Mike. Don't be stupid. I'm just the messenger.
Then give Mr. Rooney a message for me.
What is it?
So hard, in fact, even if you've got just a milligram of testosterone in your system, Hanks is going to give you a different type of Woody with just a mere mention of his name.
Help you, sir, just looking.
Here to see Tony Calvino.
Yeah, and who are you?
Mike Sullivan.
Oh, yes, sir.
Tom Hanks as Mike Sullivan oozes such a surefire confidence in every fiber of his being. Sullivan's confidence isn't lost even when Hanks is tasked with adding one of his trademark comedic tags.
Open the safe.
You're insane. You know they'll find out who you are.
The name's Sullivan. You want me to spell it? Open the box.
They'll kill you. They're animals.
You don't say.
But the hardened persona of Mike Sullivan Sr. is only part of what makes Road to Perdition so great. In many ways, Road to Perdition is a coming-of-age film through Mike Jr., as much as it's an exploration of an atypical father-son relationship. In the early stages of the film, we see a glimpse of a father-son dynamic that's respectful yet distant, which may be more of a testament of the era more so than anything else.
Michael?
Sir?
It's awake, so I don't want to see those dice.
No, sir.
Yet, as these characters truly start to know one another, a level of comfort starts to settle in, which allows Senior to soften and Junior to harden.
Can I make one suggestion?
No! I'm doing this.
This is character development at its finest, and it's brilliantly woven into the themes of coming of age as Michael Jr. is thrusted into adulthood at the expense of lost innocence.
All right, here. Take this. Take it, Michael.
I don't want it. No.
Michael,
I don't want it.
Take it.
I don't want it, Pa!
Boy, take it! You got six shots. Get out of the car. Get out of the car. When I say get down, you get down. You don't ask questions. When I say we're stopping to eat, you stay with me. You listen to me from now on. Or you start taking care of yourself.
I can take care of myself fine. You never wanted me along anyway. You think it's my fault this happened.
Stop it, Michael. It was not your fault.
The fact of the matter is, Road to Perdition has so much going for it. In fact, maybe even too much. Or at least too much for one of my short videos, which tend to have a narrow focus. Between its A-list stars, its character actors which you know by face only, Thomas Newman's fantastic score, which is amongst his finest, and Conrad L. Hall, who won a posthumous Oscar here for his cinematography, there are plenty of reasons here to celebrate Road to Perdition. And there are plenty of reasons to see it too, even if it's just to see something different.